अच्छा हरी हाँ जी सर, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। इन द एस्टरडे क्लास वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग अ वेव नेचर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन व्हिच वाज प्रपोज्ड बाय हाइगेंस एंड वाज वेल एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय मैक्सवेल। अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वी डिस्कस द सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ वेव इज as per wave theory, the characteristics of wave we discussed. But this wave theory explains interference and diffraction of waves. But this theory cannot explain some factors. Those are black body radiation, photoelectric effect, variation of heat capacities of solids with temperature, emission spectrum of hydrogen. So these are not explained by wave theory. So to overcome these drawbacks, scientists have started studying the nature. What is black body? What is black body radiation? What is photoelectric and all those? After that, particle nature of electromagnetic means particle theory, which is also called as crystal theory. The particle nature of electromagnetic radiation was proposed by the scientist Max Planck. So Max Planck proposed the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation, which is known as the Kreisler theory. Yeah, before that, first we'll discuss what is black body, what is black body radiation, what is photoelectric effect, what are the consequences of that photoelectric effect. Let us see black body. Black body means the body which is in black color is not black body, not like that. So black body means the substance which is a perfect absorber and perfect emitter. Means when the radiation is allowed to fall on an object, it should absorb all the radiations fall on it. At the same time, what the radiations are absorbed, the total radiation should be emitted with another wavelength. So the substance which is a perfect absorber and perfect emitter is called as black body. So black body is a substance which is a perfect absorber and a perfect emitter of all radiations. So it can absorb any radiation which is fall on it, and it can re-emit all the radiations with another wavelength or in another form. So let us take an example for black body. Actually, there is no perfect black body in the universe. Means no substance can act as a perfect absorber as well as perfect emitter. Okay, see, when radiation is made to fall on object, three possibilities are there. So when radiation is allowed to made to fall on object, some amount of radiations get absorbed. This is one possibility, and some may get transmitted, and some may get reflected. So three possibilities are there. Some radiations may absorb, some are reflected, and some may be transmitted. Three possibilities are there, right? But so the body which absorbs all the radiations made to fall on it, that is a black body. Like that, no substance is present in the universe. There is no perfect black body in the universe, but a halo sphere. So this is a halo sphere, which is inside coated with a platinum black, nothing but a finely divided platinum. Finely divided platinum is nothing but termed as platinum black. Having a fine hole. So this can act nearly as a black body. A hollow sphere, which is inside coated with a platinum black, can act as nearly black body. Then how it acts as a black body? See, when some radiation is allowed to fall, is passed through this black body, then when the radiation strike here, the platinum surface, some amount of radiation are absorbed by this black body and some will be reflected, not transmitted here. This is a thick metal wall, so cannot be transmitted. Some radiation get absorbed and some get reflected. And what the reflected radiation is there, they can strike at another surface. Again, here some radiation get absorbed and get reflected here. Like this, number of internal reflections takes place. Radiation get reflected number of times internally. Internal reflection takes place. So like this, in each reflection, some amount of radiation get absorbed, remaining get reflected. Like that, due to number of reflection that takes place inside the halo sphere, the total radiations are absorbed by the body, what is mentioned here. That means this acts as a perfect absorber. Here, at the same time, this halo sphere, what the radiations are absorbed by this halo sphere, can be re-emitted with another wavelength than what we have passed here. What the radiation we have passed is having certain wavelength. So other than that wavelength, with some other wavelength, the radiation get emitted. So this is an example of a black body. So there is no perfect black body in the universe, but a halo sphere which is inside coated with the platinum black can access black body. Okay, so this is an example for a black body, right? Now let us see here, what is black body radiations? See, nothing but the radiations which are emitted by the black body are called as black body radiations. See here, what we are passing radiations, those are absorbed by this black body. Again, this black body can re-emit the total radiation what is absorbed here. And what the radiation that are emitted here, these are nothing but called as black body radiation. Is the radiation emitted by the black body is called black body radiation. Let us see the black nature of this black body radiation here. See, if you plot a graph between the wavelength of the radiation what was emitted by the black body and intensity, between intensity of radiation and wavelength of the radiation, if you plot a graph at a given temperature, then you can get the graph like this. We assume this is 1000, 2000, 3000, and so on. These are the wavelength in angstroms, 1000 angstroms, 2000 angstroms, and so on. And this is intensity on y-axis. So by taking intensity on y-axis, wavelength on x-axis, if you plot a graph at a given temperature T1, we can get the radiation like this. So we can get the graph like this. See, from this what we will come to know is, with increasing the wavelength, the intensity of the radiation increases or reaches to a maximum value and then decreases. That means at lower wavelengths or at higher wavelengths, the intensity of radiation will be less. So what the radiations emitted by the black body, in that radiation, the radiation with a low wavelength or the radiation with a high wavelengths are less. The moderate wavelengths intensity will be more at a given temperature. Now, at one more temperature, if you plot the same graph, which is higher than this temperature T1. This is at T2 temperature. Okay, right. That means here, if you observe, than compared at a T1 temperature, T2 temperature is more. T2 is more than T1. Okay, right. Now here also, at a T2 temperature also, with increasing the wavelength, the intensity of radiation increases, reaches to maximum value. On further increase in wavelength, the intensity further decreases. Okay, but the maximum intensity is more at higher temperature than at lower temperature. So what is the maximum intensity here at T1 temperature? This is the maximum intensity. At a T2 temperature, what is the maximum intensity? This is the maximum intensity. That means as the temperature increases, intensity of radiation increases and the maximum intensity shift towards lower wavelength. So from this, what we'll come to know is, if a black body is at low temperature, the maximum intensity is at a moderate wavelength. As the temperature of the black body increases, intensity of radiation increases and maximum intensity of radiation shift towards lower wavelengths. See one simple example I'll tell you for this. Take one iron rod and heat it. Initially, in the beginning, on heating it turns to yellow color. If you heat it further, it turns to red color. On further heating, it turns to pink color. Means that, so as the temperature increases, the wavelength of the radiation emitted changes. That's why color changes. At the same time, the intensity of radiation also increases. So at high temperature, the intensity of radiation will be more. At low temperature, the intensity of radiation will be less. Okay. Right. So this is regarding a black body radiation. See once again, if you plot a graph between intensity of radiation versus a wavelength, so if you plot a graph between intensity of radiation versus wavelength, you can get curves like this. From this, what we will come to know is, with increasing the wavelength, intensity of radiation increases, reaches to a maximum value. After reaching maximum value, with increasing further wavelength, again intensity decreases. Means intensity of radiation with very low wavelengths or very high wavelengths will be less. So intensity of radiation with a moderate wavelength will be more. For the same body at higher temperature than T1, that is at T2, if you plot the graph, we can get the graph like this. From this, what will come now is, with increasing temperature at any wavelength, if you observe, with increasing temperature, the intensity of radiation increases. And see, here maximum intensity is at this wavelength. Here maximum intensity is at this wavelength. That means with increasing the temperature, the maximum intensity shifts towards lower wavelengths. So by studying this characteristic properties of this black body radiation, Max Planck proposed a particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. That is, he has proposed a Kurzweil theory. Okay, right. This is about a black body and black body radiation. So, black body means the substance which is a perfect absorber as well as a perfect emitter of all radiations. That is called black body. There is no perfect black body in the universe. But a halo sphere which is inside coated with a platinum black can access nearly as a black body. And Max Planck has studied the variation of intensity of radiation with wavelength and temperature. So based on this, he has proposed one theory which is called as a Kurzweil theory, known as a particle theory. That is a particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. All right. Let us see, what is this Max Planck's quantum theory? Max Planck's quantum theory, that is also known as Kurzweil theory or particle theory. Means, so Max Planck proposed that electromagnetic radiations not only having wave nature, but also having particle nature. So the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation was proposed by Max Planck. And based on this Max Planck's quantum theory, so what are the important postulates of this theory is, See here, the first one is radiation is emitted or absorbed by a body due to the vibrations of charged particles. Like electrons, so energy is emitted or absorbed due to the means, that means the radiation is absorbed or emitted by a body due to the vibrations of the charged particles like electrons, means excitation and de-excitation, what is called. So this is the first postulate. Next, see, a body is in cold condition, it absorbs radiation. If a body is in hot condition, it emits radiation. See, if you take a cold iron rod, it does not emit any radiation. But if you take a hot iron rod, see that it look like as a yellow color or red color or pink color, because it emits the radiation of yellow wavelength or a red wavelength or pink wavelength, like that. So depending on the wavelength of the radiation emitted, we can observe the color. Okay, so that radiation is emitted or absorbed due to vibrations of charged particles like electrons. But one thing, see, the emitted or absorbed energy is not continuous, it is discontinuous in the form of small packets of energy, and that each small packet of energy is known as a quantum. In case of light, that energy packet is called as a photon. See, sunlight, light consists of photons. What that photon? Photon is nothing but an energy packet. So a substance neither absorb nor emit energy continuously, it is discontinuous. A substance emit or absorb radiation discontinuously. In the form of small packets of energy, known as quantum. So quantum means it is an energy packet. So the substance or a body neither emit nor absorb energy continuously, it is a discontinuous in the form of a small discrete packets of energy, and each small packet of energy is known as quantum. In case of a light, the small packet of energy is called as photon. Okay, right. Next, third one. See, the small packet of energy is called as quantum. So every radiation is associated with certain amount of energy, which is known as a radiant energy. So every radiation is associated with certain amount of energy known as radiant energy. And the third one is, the energy of this radiation is directly proportional to the frequency of the radiation. This is nothing but third postulate. The energy of the radiation is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. It implies we can equalize this by multiplying with a constant. E is equal to h nu, where h is called as Planck's constant, H is called as the Planck's constant, and the value of this Planck's constant is 6.626 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second, not joule per second, joule second. Otherwise, this can I express in terms of CCS units as 6.626 into 10 to the power of minus 27 erg second. This is so the energy of a photon is directly proportional to the frequency of the radiation. Then E is equal to h nu, where h is a proportionality constant known as Planck's constant, and the value of Planck's constant is 6.626 into 10 power minus 34 joule second, otherwise 6.626 into 10 power minus 27 erg second. Next, one more point. This is third postulate. You can write this as a statement. The energy of the emitted radiation is directly, or quantum is directly proportional to frequency of the radiation. That is the third postulate. Next, one more. Emitted or absorbed. Emitted or absorbed radiation is always quantized. Okay, so emitted or absorbed radiation or energy is always, emitted or absorbed energy. So emitted or absorbed energy is always quantized. So what is the meaning of this quantization? See, quantization means if a value is increased by integral multiples, that is called quantization. A simple example. So we'll purchase a milk in the form of packets. Okay. So by going to a shop, I will ask one milk packet or two milk packets or three milk packets. Shall we ask, give me 2.5 packets of milk, 2.5 packets of milk? Can we give? Not like that. So always they will give in whole numbers only, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Like that, in integral multiples only we can get. We cannot get in fractions. So here, quantum is the smallest packet of energy. Then that smallest packet is not available. This is the smallest packet of energy. And to the smallest packet, n times we can get. So if a quantity is increased by integral multiples, then it is called as quantization. Quantized, that is the meaning of quantization. Means E is equal to h nu. This is energy of one packet. Then E is equal to n h nu. This is energy of n packets, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. It is a whole number and integer here. So these are the major postulates of the Max Planck's quantum theory. See once again. See, every radiation is associated with certain amount of energy known as radiant energy. Radiation is emitted or absorbed due to the vibrations of charged particles like electrons. This is the first postulate. Second one, a substance emit or absorb radiation discontinuously, not continuously, that is in the form of small discrete packets of energy. And each small packet of energy is called as quantum. So the same in case of light, this is called as photons. Small packet of energy of light is nothing but known as photon. Okay, all right. Then next, third one. The energy of the radiation or energy of a photon is directly proportional to the frequency of the radiation. Then E is equal to h nu, where h is known as a proportionality constant called Planck's constant. And the value of Planck's constant is 6.626 into 10 power minus 34 joule second, or 6.626 into 10 power minus 27 erg second. Okay, so these two are constant values. You should remember these two values while solving the problems. We should use this, and the relation is E is equal to h nu. This is Max Planck's equation. And so this is the energy of one photon, not the total radiation. The radiation contains n photons. Then the total energy of radiation is always equal to integral multiple of energy of one photon. That means n times of h nu. So the total energy of radiation is equal to integral multiple of energy of photon. So E is equal to nh nu. So this E is equal to nh nu represents the total energy of the radiation. E is equal to h nu represents energy of only one photon. This is energy of one photon. This is energy of the total radiation. So this is regarding the important postulates of Planck's quantum theory. So according to this Planck's quantum theory, electromagnetic radiation is having both wave nature as well as particle nature also. In the form of discrete particles, the emission of or absorption of radiation takes place. Okay, right. So this is about Max Planck's quantum theory, which explains the dual nature of electromagnetic radiation. So the dual nature of light was explained according to Einstein's theory, which is nothing but E is equal to mc square based on that. Now see. So what we discussed here now, E is equal to h nu. This is energy of one photon. So if the frequency of radiation given, then we will calculate energy of radiation by this formula. Suppose if the wavelength of the radiation given, then what is energy of photon? E is equal to h. As you know, nu is equal to c by lambda. In yesterday class we discussed. That means E is equal to hc by lambda. This formula we use for calculating energy of photon when wavelength of radiation given. Suppose if wave number given, then energy E is equal to h. Nu is equal to c nu bar. Replace nu with c nu bar. So this is hc nu bar. So these are the relations what we use to calculate energy of radiation when wavelength or frequency or wave number are given. So even we can compare the energies of two different electromagnetic radiations. So if you are comparing two different electromagnetic radiation, then E2 by E1 is equal to nu2 by nu1. Because as per this equation, first equation, E directly proportional to nu, then E2 by E1 is equal to nu2 by nu1. Similarly, as per the second equation, E is proportional to 1 by lambda. Energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. That means E2 by E1, is equal to lambda 1 by lambda 2. This is second one. Next, E is equal to hc nu bar. That means E is directly proportional to nu. Means E2 by E1 is equal to nu2 bar by nu1 bar. So these are the relations. So by using these relations, we can calculate energy of photons. If you want to calculate the total energy of radiation, then the formula E is equal to n h nu. This relation what we use here. This indicates the total energy of radiation. This indicates energy of a photon. So based on these formulas, some problems they are asking. We will solve the problems later. Okay. So just remember all these formulas. So four statements, which are the postulates of Planck's quantum theory, and these are the formulas. Based on these formulas, we should solve the problems later. Right. This is about Planck's quantum theory, which explains particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. And one more. See, the dual nature of electromagnetic radiation can also be explained based on photoelectric effect. Let us see what is photoelectric effect. So itself in the what the meaning is there, photoelectric effect. Photo means light. So due to light, electric effect will be there, means current will be produced. Let us see the description here, I'll show. So this is a discharge tube. So here I have taken a anode like this, and this is cathode, and here this is connected to an ammeter. Ammeter is used to measure the current in the circuit, and this is connected to source battery. So negative first means this is cathode, and this is anode, nothing but collector. It is called collector, I'll explain, just wait. Now this is a discharge tube connected to a source. Now here, when the light is made to fall on the surface of this cathode, when the light of certain minimum frequency is made to fall on the surface of this cathode, from the surface of this cathode electrons will be ejected. This phenomenon is called as a photoelectric effect, means ejection of electrons from the surface of a cathode or metal when it is radiated with a light of certain minimum frequency. That is called as a photoelectric effect. Simply, when light having certain minimum frequency is allowed to fall on the surface of a metal, then from the surface of this metal electrons will be ejected, electrons will be released. Then how to find whether electrons are released or not? So what the electrons released here, these electrons move towards anode, and these are collected by this anode. Then how many electrons are received by this anode, that will be measured by the current shown in this ammeter. So the ammeter is used to measure the flow of current in the circuit here, means how much electrons are received by this collector, nothing but anode. Okay, so this phenomenon is called as photoelectric effect. See one second, ejection of electrons from the surface of a metal when it is radiated with a light of certain minimum frequency is called as photoelectric effect. See, as I said here, we should pass the light having certain minimum frequency nu naught, which is called as a threshold frequency. This is called as threshold frequency nu naught, means the minimum frequency required for the ejection of electrons from the surface of a metal is known as threshold frequency. Suppose if the frequency of radiation what we are passing is less than threshold frequency, then electrons will not be ejected. What the radiation we are passing here, that radiation should contains certain minimum frequency, then only electrons will be ejected from the surface of the metal, and that frequency required is called as threshold frequency. Suppose what the light we are passing here, the frequency of the light is less than the threshold frequency, then photoelectric effect is not observed. No photoelectric effect will be there, means no ejection of electrons takes place here, not possible. What the frequency of radiation we are passing here, that frequency of radiation must be greater than or at least equal to the threshold frequency, then only photoelectric effect will be observed. Okay, right. So, for the ejection of electrons from the surface of metal, we should require certain minimum frequency. Then only electrons will be ejected from the surface of metal. And that minimum frequency, what is required? That is called as threshold frequency. Okay. One more term here. Work function, represented by the symbol W. Work function symbol is W. So what is work function? See, work function W is nothing but equal to H nu naught. That means energy corresponding to the threshold frequency. Nothing but simply. See, for the ejection of electron from the surface of the metal, what is the minimum energy required? E is equal to H nu. That energy E is nothing but a work function. Means, for the ejection of electrons from the surface of the metal, what is the minimum energy required? That minimum energy required for the ejection of electrons from the surface of metal is known as work function. Okay. So, one simple example, I will tell you, explain this regarding this photoelectric effect. See, what we are using solar calculators or solar panels. So that solar calculator can work in the, when it is placed in the presence of sunlight. So if you kept in dark, it will not function. What is the reason? So for working of that calculator, some electrical energy is required, some current is required. So where that currents will come? So it contains a panel, solar panel will be there. When the light is made to fall on the surface of the solar panel, then from that panel, electrons will be ejected. That means some electric current is produced. And by that, it will function. Or what we are using, solar water heaters or solar panels for recharging the batteries. So even light, when sunlight is made to fall on the surface of that solar panels, then from the surface of the panels, electrons will be ejected. That electrons will be received by collectors, nothing but anode. That means it shows some potential difference here between cathode and anode. That means it shows some current. Okay. So, solar panels are best examples for photoelectric substances. So, for the ejection of these photoelectrons, we should pass the light to certain minimum energy. And that minimum energy required is known as work function. Okay, right. Officer, yeah. So still some more concept is there regarding this continuation part. That tomorrow we'll discuss. See once briefly. So what is photoelectric effect? Ejection of electrons from the surface of metal when it is radiated with a light of certain minimum frequency, that is called as photoelectric effect. That is called photoelectric effect. So for the ejection of electrons, we should have to pass the light of certain minimum frequency. And that minimum frequency required is called as threshold frequency. The energy corresponding to this threshold frequency is nothing but called as work function. Means the minimum amount of energy required for the ejection of electrons from the surface of a metal, that is called work function. Still